tell us the vision that you have for the church, how you're getting on through this pandemic, and what God is showing you as far as how we can occupy this world that God's put us in.
Well, it's been unique, I guess, for every pastor and every genre, denomination, as far as how they handled the pandemic. During the pandemic, a lot happened. And just to kind of tell you how it unfolded for us, the Sunday morning that I woke up to come to our church to do a live stream broadcast, our very first live stream, without people in gathering in congregation, I got a call that morning at 7:30 that my father had had a massive stroke. And so it was a literal double whammy on dealing with a new paradigm and also my father. So I'm broadcasting with a note, knowing in my mind that my father is in a hospital in Nashville. And so I went to sit with him, and for about 6 days, I was with him. He did finally pass, and I got to be there with him when he passed. And I can honestly say that when he did pass, the glory of God filled that room so strong that there was an awareness that I knew exactly where he was from that moment on. And even God, I won't go into it, but God gave me divine dreams of what was coming, how to handle it. And God is never late. He is always on time. And he put together a team here at Highlands that put all the cameras in place even before we even knew that COVID would be around, so that we didn't miss a beat to be able to preach the gospel through live stream.
That's amazing. Well, the reason why we started Daily Faith was pastors. I'm a friend to pastors. I'm not a pastor myself, but I love pastors, and I mentor many, and just I'm a big brother to a bunch of them. And they started calling, saying, what's going on? What's happening? And I said, stay tight. It's going to be cool. And when the service is a live service, I mean, we'd never conceived of having a church without being in church. And then they called me back and said, wow, our tithes and offerings aren't going down. In fact, they're going up. And I thought, well, hallelujah, that's great. Keep doing what you're doing. It made a whole bunch of churches I knew be more aware of social media, that they thought that being online was a camera stuck in a building somewhere, and the pastor's just little wee figured out in the bottom of the screen. And we've had to re-examine all of that. And most recently, pastors are contacting me saying, you know, things are, our finances are still okay, but people aren't coming back. People aren't, they're not coming back to church like we want them to. And so it's a real challenging season for the church. But I am certain of this, Jason, that as the church goes through these trials, this is the greatest opportunity for growth. David said, you have enlarged me in my distress.
Absolutely.
If you allow the season to enlarge you. Back in Scotland, I don't know if you've ever been up the Highlands, but you'll see these little gnarly trees about 8 feet out of the ground, and they're bent into the prevailing wind because the wind howls so much in the Highlands of Scotland. And you go along and there's not much trees, but once in a while you'll see this wee straggly tree sticking up, leaning over like this, and you know, hardly any leaves on it because they're blown off as well. But let me tell you something, if you dig down the roots of that tree, that tree's like got roots like you would not believe, because it's taken its power, and instead of doing this, it's done this.
Absolutely.
And I believe that the Lord uses circumstances to force you to grow your roots so that the storms that come subsequently are not such a big deal after all.
And that's what we found is when the pandemic hit, it made us take a look at who we were, but also go back to the Word to realize that every time in Scripture that pressure was placed upon the church grew. We see the dispersion in the times of Christ, when the Holy Spirit is filling people. And then we see in AD 70, even after that, the gospel grew even more. So a lot of pastors were very afraid that they didn't have people sitting right in front of them, but they actually had a greater congregation before them that was receiving.
Absolutely. Well, God uses adversity to turn. He uses it to weed people out. If your motives aren't right, he'll get right to you. I had a dear friend who's passed away recently called Arthur Burt, a great old man, great man of God. One of the generals of my memories. When I was a boy in Scotland, he would just show up in the morning. I'd be going to school and Arthur Burt would be on the doorstep. And he was prophetic and he'd come and stay for 3 or 4 days and prophesy and speak into my dad's life and my mom's life and the church's life. And then one morning you got up and he was gone. And he had a tremendous saying, you can't fix the fixer.
Mm.
God is the fixer. And he is working all things according to his purpose. And we've got to read the signs of the time. We've got to see where his heart is going and get in line with that and get in his slipstream. And when you do that, then miracles start happening. And I'm believing that is what is going to happen.